Hey guys, this is Jakob and welcome to this video. I'm going to show you how to create amazing pictures for your blog posts. So I'm writing now my book about content marketing, and one of the struggles or one of the complaints, one of the problems that people have who are creating content is how to create content that is liked and that is also shared. And one aspect of this is to use pictures that are related to your content. And how to do this is with Pablo Buffer. So when you type in Pablo Buffer at Google, you will come to this website, pablo.buffer.com. And then basically it looks like this. Nothing happens. No, here it's coming. And this is a free tool that you can use for creating your pictures for Pinterest, for Facebook, and also for Twitter. And you can, there are more than 600,000 images that you can use for free. So that's a great way. I use them for my blog posts. I use them also, I used them in the past for my Huffington Post articles. So you can use them also. It's very convenient. So for example, if you want to write something about marketing, then just type in marketing and there you have pictures, a lot. You can use them all here or this one. Let's see which one to use. It's all always related to your topic, so something like this. Yes. So now content marketing. Oops. Marketing mastery. And then you can make it a little bit bigger so it looks nice. Okay, and then you can download it. For example, this is now for Facebook, okay? You can also make some, wow, heavy contrast. Or what do we have? Red tint. No. I don't want this. I just don't need this. So then you can directly share it with your Facebook or with your Twitter account or with your Instagram account. But I would prefer to first download it. I will tell you why this is important. Just for your SEO solution, so that you are searchable on Google. It is important to make one more step. So if after you download the picture, yeah, great. Oh, this is not maybe the best thing. Maybe we change this. Doesn't look that good. So this is better. So if you can't read it, it's not a good picture. So again, download it. Takes a little while. So now that's better. And now after I download it, I change the name of it. So that's important. So for example, content marketing mastery, and then I add my name. So just when I uploaded it at my blog or at my Facebook account, so that in SEO terms, people who recognize this picture also find my name. So that's an important thing. So that's it basically. So this is how you create pictures with Pablo at Buffer for free. Please share your thoughts, what you think. Is this helpful, this video? Or do you have other questions about creating content or organizing content? I would love to answer your questions and read them. Please share what you think. Thank you and see you in the next video. Bye.